As usual, the inspiration for A Court in Thorns and Roses actually came from music. One day I was listening to the Princess Mononoke soundtrack, and there's this track called The Demon God that is like really like dark and intense and awesome, and I was listening to it, and I just heard Feyre's voice in my head narrating as she is in this snowy, dead wood, hunting a deer, and then this moment where a wolf appears across the clearing just as she's about to make like the kill shot on the deer, and I saw this whole kind of fight between her and the wolf. And as soon as I just heard this music and just heard this heroine's voice in my head, I kind of wanted to know who this huntress was, what was her world like, why would she ever risk taking on this wolf for one deer. And from that like one little moment of music, the entire world sprang up. And then the other source of inspiration for me was actually three different fairy tales, folk tales. Beauty and the Beast, which is one of my all-time favorite fairy tales. A Norwegian folk tale called East of the Sun, West of the Moon, which is my favorite folk tale, like of all of them. It's like about a super awesome heroine, very like girl power. And then also Tamlin, which I think is an English legend. And I kind of drew from those and wove them together and kind of put my own twist on them. And over the years that I was working on the book, it wound up kind of becoming its own thing, but there are nods to all of those legends woven into the book. And then the third thing that inspired me was just, like, I've always loved fairy mythology, but also, like, mythologies from, like, around the world. Like, I didn't want to stick to just, you know, the, you know, English or Celtic fairy mythology. I wanted to draw from, like, various mythologies and draw my monsters from other religions and cultures. So there are creatures in the world of A Court in Thorns and Roses that pop up in, like, Middle Eastern Hindu myths. So I... you know, that inspired me. I've always loved all the things that go bump in the night, regardless of, you know, where they come from. And what's fun about creating this fairy world is that I kind of get to do what I want with it. I can bring in these various monsters from different cultures and put my own twist on them and make them a part of this world that's, you know, entirely my own.